All right, Barberton native Alejandro Najar will compete tonight in season 21 of Hell's Kitchen, Battle of the Ages, right here on Fox. But before he does that, he decided to stop by the show to make us a classic North African and Middle Eastern dish that's great for any meal. Good morning,
first of all, man.
Congratulations. You know, excellent.
Appreciate it.
Before we get started, how did you even get on the show?
So I had, I always watched it, mm-hmm. and as a kid, I always wanted to kind of be on the show, mm-hmm. but not really because I didn't want to get yelled at. So mm-hmm. one day we were just in Columbus and somebody reached out and was like, do you want to be on Hell's Kitchen? I was like, sure. So yeah, that's kind of the gist of it.
How do you deal with Gordon Ramsay and all that yelling, man? He's pretty rough.
So he definitely has a very strong presence in the kitchen.
Yeah.
But he has every right to. You know, he does very well in America, but overseas in the UK, I mean, he's got multiple three Michelin star restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
you know, when you get on the show and you look like you're supposed to know what you're doing, and then he shows you, and then he kind of gets mad after you mess it up. I mean, I would be mad too.
Yeah, has he ever screamed at you?
I guess we'll see tonight, right?
Oh boy, here we go. Should be interesting, man.
Yeah.
All right, now you have a North African dish that you're
gonna Yeah. So the dish is called shakshuka.
Shakshuka.
And yeah, it's very simple. It's okay. just a couple ingredients. It's very tomato based.
Now, let me ask you this before you, yeah. Is this what you're gonna do for the show tonight or what?
No. Okay. No, I'm not.
This is something else.
Yeah, this is
now,
something
else. Now, tell us, first of all, before we get started,
yeah.
now, you're a chef where?
I'm a chef at Unhitched Brewing Company in Louisville, Ohio.
Okay, and is this something that you put together there?
Yeah, this is kind of like the basis of what we do. We're very much so a Middle Eastern restaurant,
nice.
But
yeah.
without being like that, we're
okay.
a brewing company,
okay.
so I just felt like the flavors of Middle Eastern, Mediterranean food went really well with
beer. Well, it smells good, I can tell you
that. I appreciate
right now.
It.
All right, now let's do it.
Okay, cool. So what we have here is a tomato-based sauce, lots of peppers, lots of spices, mm-hmm. very warm. You can make it spicy. This one's not
It's not that spicy?
No.
Okay, I was wondering.
It's too early in the morning. I don't want anybody to be killing themselves.
Okay.
So I'm going to go ahead and make a couple little divots.
Okay. Now, what's in this right here, this picture?
So this is peppers, garlic, cumin, coriander.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and then we're going to go ahead and drop the eggs in,
okay.
and we're
going to
go slightly poach them.
Okay.
They're very easy, and then from here we'll season it up a little bit.
Oh, man.
Pop a lid on.
Okay.
And then from there you're kind of just 10, 15 minutes to poach, and then
okay.
it's very easy, and it's awesome because a lot of people don't have time for breakfast.
Okay. So this would be a breakfast dish.
Actually, this is an all-day dish.
Oh, okay.
Breakfast, lunch, dinner, you can mm-hmm. switch it up, you can add whatever you want into it. That's what's so awesome about it is
yeah.
everybody has their own variations of it. So.
Right.
Yeah, so after you're done, you're left with something that's steamy and bubbly like this.
So this is the finished product.
Yes, correct.
Yeah, let me kind of just tilt it so people can see what we're looking at
yeah.
right here. How nice is that?
And then what's really cool about it, again, you can garnish it however way you want it.
Okay.
We're
going
to do feta, avocado, Ooh. And a little bit of herbs.
Wow, that sounds good. Let's see what's happening here.
So the feta, you want to add it on when it's a little warm.
Okay.
So that way you can get it a little melty.
Okay.
Lots of herbs. It's going to help counteract a lot of the fattiness from the egg and the feta.
Mm-hmm.
And then just a touch of avocado as much as you would like.
So you make it look easy.
Yeah, I mean, it is easy.
Really? Because we have the recipe on our website, fox8.com. But I mean, it's if you dare, that's all I have to say.
Yeah, we don't want to make it difficult on
right.
anybody. You know, there's a lot of people, again, who don't have time for
right.
lunch, breakfast, dinner, so if
can
you can make it all in one pan.
Can we plate this up?
Let's plate it up.
Let's see what it tastes like. And once again, you can find this at the restaurant down in, Barberton, right?
Louisville. Yeah.
You're from Barberton, the restaurant is
Louisville. So we're going to plate it up, and then what we do awesome at the brewery is that we make our own pizza dough.
Mm.
So it's a 24-hour ferment, so you get a little bit of sourdough notes into it.
I can tell.
I've eaten it too many times, so.
Alejandro, that's excellent, man.
I appreciate it.
Very, very nice. All right, man, I'm looking forward to tonight.
Yeah, me too. We'll see what happens.
All right, now, if you win...
Okay.
What does that mean?
So if you win, you get to become the executive chef at Gordon Ramsay's new restaurant, which is in Atlantic City.
Okay.
And it's a $250,000 salary. And it's a year contract. So the stakes are high. You know
are you
what
ready
I mean?
For the move?
I'm ready for the move.
I think so. That's good stuff, man.
Yes, sir.
Well, appreciate you.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you so
I
much, man.
It. Thank you.
This is very good. It's hot.
Yes.
But it's very, I mean, hot meaning it's steaming because you just took it out of there, but it's very good.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate
Thank you.
It.